Welcome OCTV, this is Savit 2007, and this is Cooler Master and Big Kisses from Us.
Hello and welcome to OCTV 3. We are actually in the CeBIT 2007 in Hanover with two other reporters. Kevin, could you present yourself, please, in a few words?
Hello, my name is Kevin, aka WLCD, one of the members of the OCTV staff. I principally work on the translations and I am the one that takes care of all the equipment, video, photo, audio, during the CeBIT.
Okay, Kevin also makes the English voice dubbing for Snoop in the English versions. And we also have with us Andreas. Andreas is the one that drove us all the way up here. Could you present yourself, Andreas, please?
Of course, I'm Andreas, aka Holz. I'm the old job man on the CeBIT and Truffman's overclocking companion.
Okay, please do not misunderstand that you just said. So we'll have in the following hours quite a lot of things to see and a lot to ask and talk about all along the CeBIT. Hello, could you introduce yourself and tell us what is your status in your company?
Hello, I have to tell you first that Corsair is an American company created 13 years ago that deals only with high-level products. It's the company's motto and the VLSI elders, Americans, so I can assure that they know what they are talking about. My status is to take care of four specific areas, more countries in fact, France, Israel, Turkey and Greece. I used to take care of Southern Europe, but as things were gaining in importance, we had to take more people in the company. So I focus only on one kind of market and I keep Greece, Israel and Turkey just for my own pleasure.
One of Corsair's products is the Dominator module. To whom is dedicated this product? Who can use it?
Quelles en sont les utilisations faites dans la promotion par Corsair?
The Dominator, a very interesting adventure. It began with a thermal dissipation study made by Micron a moment ago that made us realize that most of the calories, about 55% of them in fact, try to escape by metal conduction. This means by the wires, the PCBA, mostly the VCC layer, rather than the aerial convection. This is something that we try to generally do by adding two dissipators. So we created a product with not two, but four dissipators that became the Dominator module. This type of product is only made for pros, enthusiasts, rather than neophytes.
Deux pour le dos des puces, comme on a créé il y a maintenant 6 ou 7 ans, puisqu'on a été les premiers à lancer les modules overclocker, et deux pour le circuit imprimé. Donc clairement, ce genre de module s'adresse typiquement aux lecteurs de syndrome OC, ou aux spectateurs de syndrome OC, à savoir les enthousiastes, les overclockers, les gens qui savent, qui connaissent la belle mécanique, si je peux m'exprimer ainsi, et qui aiment le bel ouvrage.
Corsair is the first brand to make memory modules DDR2 for PC 10000. Will Corsair go making on DDR2 in spite of the DDR3 arrival on the market?
Good question. We shall see how the DDR3 will behave on the market. We are ready. There has been some mistakes done by the past with the DDR2.
Quid des chipsets? Just wait and see what happens. On nous parle en interne de
and the DDR2 has still a lot to prove with tests and such.
Si ce produit ou si ce besoin sur le marché prend rapidement, effectivement, il n'y aura pas lieu de pousser plus avant la DDR2. Maintenant, si on constate les mêmes choses, les mêmes errements, j'oserais dire, que l'on a vu il y a quelques années au passage DDR1, DDR2, ça peut avoir du sens de continuer à pousser la DDR2 en fréquence le temps que la DDR3 fasse ses marques sur le marché. Pour le moment, le débat est encore un peu ouvert, malheureusement.
In what the EPP could ease the overclocking process?
We are quite proud of EPP. It's a product that we have launched with NVIDIA about a year ago. It means enhanced performance profile. This product is not dedicated to what we call the enthusiasts. It's rather for those who know a little more than the common PC user, the ones that want to try overclocking. In the chip included in that product, there are combinations that give them this possibility to start and have a try. The real overclocker just needs a screwdriver.
Quelques combinaisons déjà certifiées qui, si je peux prendre une image, ressemblent en fait à un camp de base. On veut grimper l'Himalaya, on ne démarre pas tout en bas. On a déjà quelques camps de base intermédiaires. Donc ces gens-là qui ne savent pas vraiment trop comment faire ont déjà quelque chose pour à partir d'où démarrer. Il est bien évident que l'overclocker super velu, il n'aura pas besoin de PP. Il attaque directement avec son tournevis à lui, il a l'habitude.
What chips do you principally include in your memory modules?
The best, whatever the upmarket components. We work with Micron, Samsung, Promos, but if we cannot guarantee the module or the chip, we can guarantee the performances, the overclockability, the latency and the high voltage support.
C'est toujours le meilleur des grands noms, donc on va travailler avec des Micron, des Samsung, des Promos, mais on ne peut pas garantir que sur tel type de module, il y aura systématiquement tel type de chip. Ce que l'on garantit, c'est que la performance, l'overclockabilité, les temps de latence, que l'on, la tenue en tension que l'on garantit au client, il les aura. Maintenant, si d'aventure on passe de Micron à Samsung, c'est qu'on a jugé utile, c'est que ça tenait, qu'on a jugé utile de le faire.
Corsair proposes 520 and 620 watts power supplies. Do you think that it will go to 1 kilowatt?
Yes, I can tell you that now we are working on the project of 750 watts power supply, and most certainly we will see 1 kilo in the future. We are going to do this with pleasure, knowing the success that the two other power supplies encountered in the past.
Néanmoins, c'est un petit peu la course pour le plaisir de la course en ce moment, car on sait très bien qu'une 620 watts, même avec deux GT8800, ça va très bien, ça fait très bien l'affaire. Ceci dit, on est prêt, la 750 va bientôt sortir. Et on est poussé et rassuré à faire ceci, parce que la réaction sur la 520-620 a été excellente jusqu'à présent.
What is Corsair's opinion about overclocking? What is Corsair's opinion about overclocking?
Most certainly positive. We have made the living of it. The overclockers have made Corsair and still do grant us their trust. This is why they will always be our favorite customers and why we do everything to create new products for them. A few years ago, it was more or less forbidden to get your fingers in a PC and play with components the way overclockers do. It is today not the case, and we have decided to remain to their service.
Monter en fréquence, descendre en temps de latence, c'est vraiment notre cœur de cible, c'est les gens qu'on adore, c'est les gens qu'on veut servir.
Are there new products that will be introduced in the market by your company in 2007 and 2008 years?
Let's start by 2007 with the Dominator and the Dual Heat Exchange. As time went by, we realized that we could create a product like the Dominator that could be on the less high-level products on the market. And this was because the Dominator was gaining more importance against the AXSM2, a common dissipator. The future will see more of the Dominator module type, with more than one dissipator. These new dissipators with this new heat spreading technology that don't need to be so high-end products. So these products, will soon be launched on the market. In PC 6400, 8500, but not in 8800 or 10,000.
Mais sans aller aussi haut de gamme que le Dominator. Ça n'aura donc pas le nom du Dominator, ça en aura le look et surtout ça aura les spécificités thermiques, mais pas nécessairement le très haut de gamme. On devrait voir les premiers kits sortir en 6400, petit à petit probablement en 8500, mais on ne parle pas du tout encore de 8888 ou 10000 ou 9136.
Thank you, Christian. Is there anything else you would like to add?
À l'équipe de Syndrome OC en général.
Mais avec plaisir.
Of course. I must say that I remember OCTV at its beginnings, and I am glad to see that you are doing well. OCTV has found its path.
J'ai trouvé l'idée excellente, et je vous parie que ça va continuer longtemps, parce que les premiers sont toujours les mieux servis de toute façon. Il y a un créneau à prendre, et je suis assez content de cette expérience, surtout venant d'Overclocker.